define the word entitled? What does entitled mean to you?
I would say, in a nutshell, it is something that is, maybe, I might be wrong, innately that we have. That, for example, if I say, if I give you a coffee, I would expect a thank you. Or I would maybe be entitled to not be abused or insulted. It's an entitlement that you don't have to give. It's something that I expect. So do you get it? It's something that I expect subconsciously, but it's not something that you have to do. But when you don't do it, it tells me a little bit about you. So if you come and say, Ali, here you go. This is, I bought you an iPhone 13, argument's sake, yeah? And I say, okay, bye. Now that says a lot about who I am now. And it tells you a lot about who you are. So in a nutshell, what I'm just trying to say is that when we give these scenarios, is that when it's a woman, or when a woman cries, it's why men are more psychologically weaker, I believe. Yeah, and we see that. Yeah, women tend to get over relationships faster. There's studies that show that. You know, you have that meme which shows, you know, first week of breakup, the man is like, woo, and the girl's like, woo, and then 3 weeks later, the guy's crying and the woman's, we see that. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So I'm just saying, let's just be consistent and accept this fact that if a man, for example, is married, loves his wife, he's good to his wife, and he wants to have intimacy, and he calls her to have intimacy, and she says no, that is a form of abuse. I believe that. And if anyone can tell me why I'm wrong, I'll respect that. It's the same way, you know, I believe it's a form of abuse if she's being attacked and I just watch it happen. How?
Because, like,
yeah, one consequence, sister, is that one's going to kill you, the other one doesn't. Like, the refusal of intimacy doesn't kill the man, but in an instance where a man takes a step back and lets his wife get stabbed, that's death. So one is worse off.
Yeah, but those are two very different scenarios.
Well, it is, but that's the they're both.
It's a bit of a straw man to compare.
But why is it straw man?
Because one is one person being attacked, one person being killed.
Exactly.
Other person is withholding.
But based on biology, yeah, we're talking about. Decision. But we're talking about how men and women are created. Yeah. That's why I'm giving you that example, because one is an example of how we are created when it comes to the sex drive, and the other is how we're created based on our physical abilities. So I'm saying, as a man, I have these. This is my weakness. For example, a man's weakness is. He has a high sex drive, he has to have intimacy. A woman's weakness is she's physically weak. So I need to cater for her there, and she will need to cater for me here. Now this doesn't mean, both. If a man says to his wife, come and have intimacy, she says no, I believe that man should say, you know what, I want to end this relationship. I'm not saying you should go and force yourself on her. This is, which man would in their right mind do that? I'm not saying that. I'm saying what she's doing is abuse, and he has a right for divorce.
Well, don't you think that it might be better for men to get better at controlling their sex drive?
No, this is absolutely, you know what this is, bruv? You're kicking the guy on the floor, bang. Yeah, you're kicking me, that's what you're doing. And as a man, how could you say that? How could you say that as a man? He's been refused intimacy, and on top of that, you control your sex drive. And studies show that the way a man is created, that his sex drive is nowhere compared to woman. And on top of that, woman, can you imagine if you said this to a woman? Imagine studies show a woman's sex drive is higher than a man's. And then she's like, well, I want intimacy, he's not giving it to me. Sister, control your sex drive. What's wrong with you? You know what, bruv, you know what they'll say to us? This guy, he said, this guy's a valium, he's an oppressor. He's an oppressor. This is what I'm saying. I don't think it's right. I think we need to really, you know, and like I said before, in Islam we have a hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him, where a woman came and complained that her husband doesn't sexually satisfy her. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, allowed the divorce to happen. So in Islam, it's not like, oh, no, if a woman is not sexually satisfied, she has a valid reason for divorce.
Yeah, exactly. No. So divorce is there.
Ah, exactly, for the woman.
Yeah,
ah, okay.
What
happened to the man?
If somebody isn't being satisfied in a relationship, then you keep it moving.
No, I know. What I'm just trying to say in a nutshell is that man not giving intimacy to his wife is abusing her, and the vice versa is worse, because for a man, the studies show it's, yeah.
I think it's been a bad partner. It's not being very good in a relationship, yeah. You know, because you're not actually trying to satisfy a partner. But it doesn't mean abuse. Abuse is a strong word to use. And if you're confused...
Depends on situation to situation.
It's like somebody being hit on the ground or comparing that to somebody withholding sex. When it's a completely different ballgame.
But it is.
And it's risky to compare to it.
Which one? The sex. Because obviously, you could say that, like, her denying him his rights,
yeah.
You've joined in that marriage,
yeah.
And you're both entitled to intimacy. Yeah. So if one of them is like, she has more control in that situation, she's saying that.
Yeah.
So if you're denying someone of their rights in a marriage,
yeah.
Then that is, I would say that's slightly a form of, you've both got agree to that, you can join in that marriage.
It's for both parties, but based on the studies that we have, shows that it is not as bad as me saying no to my wife. Because my sex drive studies show is much more, and we know that, visually, come on, bro, you've got strip clubs, yeah, you got prostitutes, excuse my language, I'm so sorry, sister, but there's women, that men are visual. You don't see women going and buying magazines to look at men's calves. It's not like that.
But is there any rights in a relationship?
Sorry?
Is there any rights or entitlement in a relationship?
You have to. What she's saying is that, no, there's no entitlement. If that's the case, imagine coming across every man and he says, you have no entitlement for anything from me. Yeah? So then, okay, how does it even function? What kind of, okay, no, you have no entitlement, I have no entitlement. Okay, what does that mean? Okay, can I have intimacy? Yes. Oh, I changed my mind. Oh, sorry.
Bro, yeah. Entitlement, I feel like,
bro, the point is this, yeah? If you want to have sex with somebody, that person has to want to do it.
The point is
yes. They would have to want enough. Whatever the reason is that she said no,
yeah.
Whatever the reason is,
yeah.
Why would you still want to have sex with her when she doesn't
it's not,
want
it's not
to
about
do
wanting
it.
To have sex with her. It's
it
about.
Doesn't matter what the reason
it's
is.
Not about wanting. Trust me, no one in their right mind.
She doesn't want to do it.
No, that's fine, but it doesn't work like that.
Manipulate her.
No, it's not manipulate her. No. Why is it manipulate? Are you Muslim?
I don't want to.
No, I'm just asking. Are you Muslim?
I don't care. You're going to go down that road.
No, I'm not going down that road. I want to know your worldview. Like, are you Muslim?
The point I'm trying to make is.
Okay, what's your worldview?
She would have to want to do it.
I never said she would not want to do it. No.
Now, if you say, oh, that's abuse.
Why isn't it abuse?
That's the only point I'm going to make.
Okay, why is it not abuse, though?
Because why would you want to have sex with somebody who doesn't want to?
No, you're not understanding. You don't understand the point. No one's talking about forced sex. I'm saying, is it abuse? Is it abuse if a woman says no knowingly? I'm saying knowingly she says no. Is it abuse or not?
I'll ask you a question and you can carry on.
Okay.
No, it's not abuse.
Okay. All right. I'm walking down the road. I'm walking with. One second. No. One second. I'm walking down the road.
I'm just going to define abuse quickly.
Yeah, please find it. Yeah. I'm walking down the road and I'm with a woman, my wife, and a man comes with a knife. And I tell her, darling, go sort this out. Is that correct?
I don't see how you went from that situation.
It's very simple. Very simple. It's very simple. Can you?
You went off on a tangent.
Not at all. Can you answer that question?
I'm not even going to entertain you.
Thank you very much. I thought so. Thank you very much. I'm not going to entertain it. I'm not going to entertain it. Thank you very much. No, one second. Let me get a definition first.
Yeah, so right. Let me get a definition.
Okay, one second.
So, to use something to a bad effect or purpose of misuse.
Thank you.
Or to treat with cruelty or violence, especially regularly or repeatedly.
Thank you. So what was the first one, the first sentence?
To use with bad effect or for bad purpose.
Thank you. So one second, if the woman's purpose is to make him suffer, that is a form of abuse. When I give you the example of me and my wife walking and a man with a knife and I tell her to go and deal with the situation, why do you avoid that?
I didn't avoid it.
You did, you just said avoid it. You said, no, don't talk about that. Why not? Why is it there?
There's a knife involved in that situation.
Yes, one, exactly.
It's a totally different scenario.
Exactly, one is life and death.
Knife involved.
Exactly.
Obviously
my point.
I'm going to react.
No, but that's
obviously
my point.
Somebody could potentially get killed.
No, but that's that's my point.
So with this husband and wife having or not having sex, there's no knife involved.
Yes.
Nobody's going to die.
But that's my point. It's
so
worse.
It's a different argument. If you can't see that, I can't help
you. No. But that's the situation. Is a woman more stronger physically than a man?
Is a woman
stronger physically than a man?
Generally, no.
Okay. So in that situation, am I not abusing her in that sense where I am allowing her, physically not stronger, to go and fight a man with a knife?
I don't even want to discuss this man with a knife, bro.
No. I'm giving an example. Why are you avoiding it? I'm saying,
no, I'm not.
Isn't
no.
it? Okay.
Okay.
Am
I'm not avoiding it.
Okay.
A man with a knife, I would do everything to stop it.
No. If you and your wife are walking.
I didn't really want to get into a long.
But you made a claim. You made a claim. No, but what I'm saying is.
Man with a knife.
You're making a claim. No, why? Why would you stop it? What if you said you don't want to stop it?
Because somebody could potentially get killed.
No, what's it? What if you chose to say, I don't want to get involved, and you say, I wouldn't. If you chose to say to your wife, you go and stop him.
Because somebody could potentially,
is that right or wrong?
I'm likely to be physically stronger than her. And
I'm not saying that, but I'm saying if you...
I've answered your knife situation.
You're a bit of a what?
You've been
a bit of a scumbag if you know.
But one second, so you're a scumbag, you're a scumbag, according to... One second, you are, by the way, somebody will say you're a cowardly you're a scumbag for not helping your wife, okay, because she's physically weaker, but when physically, biologically, a man's sex drive is higher than a woman's, and a woman, one second, a woman says no on purpose, it's not abusive. Wow. Wow. That's all I can say. Wow. Double standards. Double standards. Absolute double standards. And this is why, let me tell you something, that's why men like you suffer. I'll tell it to your face. You know why? Because you have just, let's be real here. Why are you making it out to be, you're a man. If you go out and we're all visual, you go home to expect, you go home and you want to have intimacy with your wife and your wife says no. Not men says, not tired. I'm not talking about that.
Okay.
Yeah, one second. And not only that, it says to you, control your sex drive.
Or reconsider the relationship. But I'm not
talking about that. Brothers, can you please, am I misconstrued? Please help me.
No.
All I'm saying is, look, just as you said, I would never do that, because if you did, it's a strange situation, right? I'm saying there's a strange woman here. As well as the strange man who wouldn't help his wife, I'm talking of a strange woman.
How many times does she have to say no?
Not how many times. Very simple. We read the definition. If she is doing it to cause some kind of a harm, it is abuse. Simple. Psychological abuse. Thank you, sister. Thank you. Actually, it's psychological. Sorry, my bad. Psychological abuse. Okay, it might be my fault. Yeah, I take it.
Okay, I'll get you from that angle.
Yeah, it's because when you're in a relationship, you're expected to be with that person.
Yes.
So if you're going to be intimate with that person,
yeah,
and they're refusing you, you're not allowed to go elsewhere. So you're trapped. And
thank
you.
You. Now you know what? You know.
So you're now questioning what's wrong with
thank you, sister.
Something wrong. Yeah.
Not only that, sister. Like for example, the Prophet peace be upon him said, yeah, he said when you're out and about, and if you see something, let's say you see a girl dressed up inappropriately, and his sex drive urges, the Prophet said, run back to your wife. Now imagine you run back to your wife. Darling, really frustrated. She says, no, control your sex drive.
Well, she might know she's married to a pervert.
Well, we better not be a pervert. No.
He's checking
everything. No, not checking, not checking.
No, sister.
No.
Control yourself, you're gay.
No, you're right. But I'm not talking about that kind of man. The Prophet said, if a man, because you see, sometimes I'm a man, you might happen to see something you don't want to. It's not you're looking. Looking at, bro, sometimes I can't even drive on the road. I can't even look left or right, bro. I can't even look on my phone. Everywhere is mashup. So the thing is, if you happen to see, not you're looking, that's your sinning. Because Allah says, tell the believing men to lower your gaze. So the point is this, if you happen to see, yeah, and this is what we're seeing, the study shows men are visually, we are visual creatures, sister, yeah? You guys will never get that. If you was in our shoes for a second, you would rip your hair out in summer, walking in London, yeah? May Allah have mercy on us. That's why I like when it rains and, you know, it's cold. Yeah, even when it's cold, it's peak, yeah? So the thing is, you go back to your wife, and the wife says, well, control your sex drive. I believe that's a form of abuse, because as Muslim men, we're not allowed to cheat on our wives. It's haram, it's a major sin, it's adultery, it's capital punishment. So the thing is here, you're not allowed to do that. So it's not like some, I'm not saying people don't believe in God cheat, but sometimes you get some guys who have side chicks and mistresses on the side. They're like, all right, no problem, man, we'll go, you know, move to some other. We as Muslim men, we fear God. We're not going to go and do that, yeah? The most we'll do is get married again. Like, do you get what I'm trying to say? But the point is here, in that very instance, that is psychological abuse. And we should accept there's nothing wrong with that. It's fine. And like I said, and there's a hadith of the Prophet.
And both ways.
Sister, there's a hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him. A woman came and said, my husband doesn't sexually please me. The Prophet said, divorce. If that was the case that we men, Muslim men, were allowed to force ourselves, the Prophet would say, shut up, go and give him what he wants.
And wasn't there instead of 3 months, it's only 1 month?
Yes. So if, for example, if she gets cholera, if I'm not mistaken, it'll be 1 month, yeah? And this is, look, Islam, I believe Islam gives the best rights to women, yeah? The biggest fraud women are living with today is dating. Oksum billah, I'm telling you. Do you know how many women I speak to are broken? They're in relationships, yeah? In relationships, and you have no security. You're with a guy. Sorry, I'm changing the topic, yeah? You're with a guy, you have no security. He hasn't spoken to your dad, he hasn't spoken to your brother, he hasn't, his intention is nothing. You get in a relationship, and most women, you know what they think of this? They see it as, oh, it was just, I had a boyfriend, it didn't work out. No, darling. He's just a polygamous man who just used his next victim, and he's going to move on to another one, and he's going to carry on the cycle. Because why would he get married when you've given him everything he wants? Islam protects a woman. How? If I'm interested, like for example, when I met my wife, yeah, we spoke, and the second day I spoke to her dad on the phone. I would like to get to know your daughter for marriage. If I'm after the wrong reasons, but why do you want to speak to your dad? I don't want to speak to your dad. Your dad is the last person I want to speak to. Islam protects a woman, number one. How? If my intention permission is the right, I speak to the father. I get the permission from the father. Secondly, you have a chaperone. You have a chaperone. Now, why do you have a chaperone? Because the Prophet, peace be upon him, said when a man and a woman is alone, the third person is Satan. It's like petrol and fire. No man. I was speaking to a brother yesterday. He's like, nah, you know me, Allah created me differently. I said, brother, move away from me, man. Allah created you differently. Yeah? Okay. Don't try that. Any man, Allah talks about Yusuf alayhi salam in the Quran, Joseph. He was being seduced by a woman. Allah said, if we was not to show him our signs, he may have inclined. So what I'm just trying to say is that you speak to the dad, you have a chaperone. What's a chaperone for? So things, you get to know each other in a right way, but you have somebody who's keeping an eye. The brother, might be the father might appoint somebody, so you just get to know each other. So if you guys are walking hand to hand, that's haram. If you're walking, he's just here, you're just keeping an eye, yeah? Why? Because the guy might be a manipulative guy. He might just, you never know. If they're together, and I hear the stories, brother, I hear it. And next thing leads on to something else, and then she's hurt. A man will put a fob and a beard, he's finished. Halas, righteous, he repented. A woman, you're finished, you're tarnished, you're done. It's sad reality, but in the sight of Allah, they're both wrong. So then you have mahar, a dowry. So a woman has a right to ask for whatever she likes, yeah? Okay. Sorry, it reminded me of back in the Jahil, I used to listen to T.I. He said, you can have whatever you like, you know. But anyways, so you basically, in a nutshell, whatever she likes. Well, if she asks for £1 million, she's not going to get married. But the point is this, she has that mahar. What's that for? That's her security. So let's say she wants £5,000. If I'm after the wrong thing, do you think I'll pay £5,000? Or I would want to go to some of these girls, I don't know, God knows what they charge, yeah? That is a woman's security that Allah put a protocol in place to protect her. But what happens today is that girls get into these relationships, get heartbroken, they don't know how to love anymore, they are insecure, they don't know how to trust, they have been broken. We know a woman who was, she was presenting at Love Island or something like that. She killed herself. Because she was saying, bruv, I get in a relationship, and I think, yeah, this is it. Uses me, bye bye. Next relationship, do you know how that mentally destroys someone? Can you imagine you get someone and then, yeah, I love you, you're the one, yeah, blah, 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 everything that you want to hear, and then after what he gets, see you later, yeah, it didn't work out. This is the reason why you have women that are broken today. And then you have men, good men, who are coming across this woman, and these women sadly break these men because they don't know what love is. They don't know how to trust. They think, oh, is he going to be like him? It's a sad reality. And this is why I was talking about mental health and all this kind of stuff. Anyway, this was a sermon. I don't know why I went on a tangent. But the point in a nutshell is that, thank you for listening, guys. All the best.